Okay, next question. How do I respond to the statement, our brain needs sugar or glucose to function properly? And this goes back to what you said before. Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
About the ketone supplements, right? And that they're probably gonna find their place.
And
specifically with a keto, or excuse me.
And gluconeogenesis.
And gluconeogenesis, that's right, okay. So ketone supplements directly here because I think there will be a place for them, as I said before, in brain health. So, people get this all the time. You know, you're gonna get goofy if you don't have carbohydrates to feed your brain. You know, you're going to have problems thinking. You're gonna be impaired, you know, in your work maybe that takes intense focus. And the answer is actually the total opposite to all those things, okay? So our brain needs carbohydrates to function when we're eating a lot of carbohydrates, okay? When we go and start a ketogenic diet and our ketone levels increase, our brains can get a big chunk of the energy they need directly from those ketones. And in fact, again, I'm gonna bring back the brain health aspect of this again, is that it actually appears that the brain prefers to be fueled by ketones. And that's why I think it's going to be an important part of treating many neurologic diseases in the future. It already is a big part of treatment for some neurologic diseases such as epilepsy. So again, preferred fuel source, ketones, the brain still will need a little carbohydrate, but it's gonna get plenty of that from gluconeogenesis, as Britt said. So your brain's gonna be fed well. In fact, so many people report when they're on a ketogenic diet, focus increases, energy increases. They get rid of that carb fog that goes on and they actually find themselves performing better. So this is not a concern for anyone on a ketogenic diet. But I understand that there may be questions, and that's how I would answer it. I'm just gonna give you the one sentence quick answer to say to everyone. Brains prefer carbs when they're fed carbs. When they're fed fat instead of carbs, they love to have the ketones as an energy source, and any bit that they still need from glucose will be fed because the body will produce that glucose needed.
And can we say that those statements usually come from the first week or two of someone trying to adapt? There is a keto adaptation process.
Absolutely.
That can take up to 6 weeks or longer to fully feel the benefits. So that first week or so, yeah, you feel that little brain fog.
Right.
But that
it goes
subsides
away quickly,
yes,
and improves to,
yes,
functioning much better than you were before.